Nice to see you. I can barely see you, but you guys are the last ones standing. Thank you so much for hanging in there. Today has been absolutely incredible. The panelists, the speakers, the messages, it's been really inspiring. And just, I got to tell you, that last group that was up here, the Web3, whew, like, that was incredible. Just to think about how other people see things and just the creativity and how beautiful the mind works. It was so special, and so I'm glad I was sitting backstage and having a chance to listen to them, because it's important to have spaces like these to be able to bring folks together. And so with that, I want to make sure that we recognize our hosts for the Economic Outlook Summit and bringing us together and giving this this opportunity to be with one another. So I think some of them are out there, but let's give a hand to them. All right, so I think it's fitting that we started the day off talking about leadership. And with that, being able to close out with the connection of leadership as well. I also know that I am the only thing standing between you and Friday Eve and whatever the drink, eat, and marry that they talked about in the last panel. So hopefully I will engage you for a few minutes and then you will be free to go. But I'm just so delighted to be with you all here today. I love sharing information with other people about your backgrounds and where you're from. And so whenever I get a chance to speak with others, I like to give a little bit about myself, because we're all connected in some way, right? And we find commonalities with one another. Even just earlier today, I met a gentleman just earlier this week for the very first time, Adam Smith. I still see you back there in the middle. Hey there. As I was walking into the hotel just today, he introduced me to one of his colleagues. And just that quickly, he's been in Salt Lake for just over a year, and he was looking for a connection with the Utah Jazz. And how quickly we make that connection, and that we'll be able to connect beyond just today and continue to help one another. And so it's so important to know where people are from, what experiences that they've had. And so I'm not gonna go through all of this, but at least this tells you a little bit about me and my background and my experience. As mentioned, I'm currently the Utah Jazz CXO. See me after if you wanna learn what that is. I usually get the question, what's a chief experience officer? We'll talk later. But my background is, I'm a military brat. Moved all over the country when I was little. I have an older brother and older sister. We all received athletic scholarships to Division I institutions. I am a crazy dog lady. That picture should be up there. So yes, I lived in a condo in Chicago with two Great Danes and three labs with no yard. That was an incredible time. I spent a lot of time in collegiate athletics, 2.5 decades. And so moving to the Utah Jazz, this was my first time in the pro space and could not be more excited about our organization as well as what the team is doing this year. I have to tell you, as I was sitting out there with you guys, seeing the bright highlighter yellow up on the stage, I was like, oh, we're right at home here with these colors. This is amazing. But also, I'm a little sister. I'm a TV broadcast dropout, and just so grateful to be with all of you today. So I get the great opportunity to talk about leadership through connection. I think it's so fascinating that leadership has changed over time. Leadership just isn't about being someone's manager or being a boss or making decisions, right? Being a leader means being responsible for others. We heard it a number of times in the other panels where we talk about the people, right? Here I say it's all about the people. Take care of your people and they will take care of the enterprise. What did we hear earlier? Invest. Invest in your people, promote your people, recognize your people, appreciate and show the value in your people. Because we all know, because we've been in those seats, when we feel valued, we feel that we are an active contributor to the organization, what happens? We go above and beyond, right? So if we invest in our people, they will invest in us, in our organization. And so I would always say, people are paramount to everything that we do. A couple of quotes here that I've enjoyed sharing in the past. The first, leadership is based on inspiration, not domination, on cooperation, not intimidation. right? When you hear those words, I think probably automatically you're thinking about, hey, I know an inspiring leader. Or on the flip side, yeah, I know someone who's a dominating leader, right? And so when you think about leadership, what does it mean to you? Where do you thrive with the people that you get a chance to work with? For those of you in a leadership position, how do you make sure that you are having a positive influence on all those individuals who are in your charge? The other quote I'd like to share with you is, leadership is not about titles, positions, or flowcharts. It's about one life influencing another. Just for a second, think about someone that you've had the opportunity to work with, a manager, a CEO, a boss, and they make you think about that, to where their way of operating, their way of working with you, their way of empowering you, developing you, where they've influenced you in your career, in your job. Those people matter, right? They make us better. They make us want to do more. And so it's so important in terms of how do we lead, how do we engage with people. So several years ago, I had a great opportunity to go to a leadership summit in Chicago, Illinois. General Colin Powell was one of our panelists. Unfortunately, we've lost him in recent years. But he wrote this book. So if you're looking for any books to read, it is The 13 Rules on Leadership. I highly recommend it. But he's up there on the stage in front of like an auditorium of 17,000 people. And they're just doing this fireside chat, and they're having this conversation. And the very first thing about his 13 rules was, it is not as bad as you think. It will look different in the morning. And so the moderator was like, all right, well, tell us, how does it look different in the morning? And his immediate response was, well, maybe it won't. And so imagine like this large crowd just erupting in laughter, like, well, wait a minute, that doesn't jive. You just told me it was gonna look different in the morning, and now you're on a stage telling me it doesn't. And so he's like, well, let's take a moment, let's clarify. got a little show music, thank you. He's like, your perspective will be different in the morning. Isn't that what everybody tells you? Sleep on it. If you're having a bad situation, if you've had a bad encounter, they're like, just sleep on it, right? And so that's what he means. After you've had a moment to step back from something, give it some thought, then it's gonna look different in the morning, and I thought that was really great advice. The other two, which is really when you talk about leadership and connection, is remain calm, but more importantly, be kind and share credit. I had an opportunity to serve on a panel just last night up at Westminster, and one of the key themes of the conversation that we had was, where did kindness go? You know, everything that we're doing in an office and an organization has become more transactional, right? And getting things done, and we lose the opportunity to connect with people. And so the opportunity to get to know one another, to work with one another, to recognize people and who they are and what their beliefs are and what's important to them, it builds apathy and empathy where you need that, right? Empathy, excuse me. And so being kind is so important. So whether you're in your office, whether you are in your community, whether you're in your church, we tend to lose sight of being kind. And when and how can we bring kindness back into just everyday life? So leadership styles, right? When you talk about the type of leaders you are, the type of leaders that you get to work with, the type of leader that you aspire to be, you can Google it. There's so many out there. I'm not going to go through all of them. But there's several that really stand out to me and resonate, and I hope they do with you as well. But it's really important to you as well, because again, as you connect with people, as you engage with them, as you learn from one another, because when you're in a workspace, it really is all about collaboration. If you can find the way to connect, it's only going to make sure that everybody is successful. So I love these different types of leadership styles. Democratic. Everybody wants to work in a democratic environment, right? To where your words and your voice matter. You have value. You're invited to participate at the table. You heard someone earlier talk about, it doesn't matter if you have diversity if you don't have inclusion, right? So democratic is so wonderful in terms of the workspace. Situational leadership, that's actually one of my favorites, because we all know we're human, right? And human nature means we all come to the table differently with our stuff and our baggage. And so to understand your tone and your body language and the way that you address work with people might be different from staff member to staff member. So if you take a moment to focus on situational leadership, then you can reach a lot more people. But the one that I find is tried and true and is really what it's about when you talk about connecting with people is servant leadership, right? Servant leadership means, really, I'm willing to do anything that I'm willing to ask you to do. I'm willing to serve with you, to fight with you, to work with you, to connect, to collaborate. Being a servant leader creates just a lot of connection when you think about working in the same space and being around others. And you look up to people, right? Like, I find myself when I'm working around others who might be in a higher position or a position of power, and you see that they're just like us. They're just like you and me. And so servant leadership really stands out to me when you talk about the connection of people and how to be a great leader. Leadership best practices. Now, I'm so grateful to be in front of all of you today and to share in this keynote space. These things are not new to you, right? We've all heard these, we've all lived them, we try to aspire to them, but sometimes we just forget. We forget what it's like to be with people and how to engage with folks. And sometimes we just need friendly reminders, right, about what's important and how we can elevate the work of our organization. Leadership best practices. So many people just want to feel validated, right? You want to know that your work matters and what you do is valued. So giving credit. It's so important to what we do because people, I mean, think about all the folks that you've heard from today, all their stories, all their insight, all their experience and their background in education. That's incredible. But if they don't necessarily hear from their peers or from their managers about the great work that they're doing or even recognizing the work that they're trying to accomplish, we sometimes lose people, right? And we don't want that. So finding and giving credit to people is so important. Creating a space for everyone to win. This is one I've talked about recently with a colleague of mine. There is enough good in this world for everybody to be celebrated for their contributions, right? And it doesn't have to be a competition. We are all in this together, so when my colleague wins, I win. When I win, our organization wins. So imagine if we created a space that was free of competition, but just really did focus on the celebration of all the hard work that everybody is doing and all of their great successes. So I think it's so important to create an environment where folks can succeed. Give the benefit of the doubt. How often have we had issues where we hear something or we sense something is wrong and we have issues internally within our organization? And it makes for tough conversations and challenges within the office, right? But if we all just took a step back, right, and meet people where they are at, and take time to understand someone might be having a bad day, something might be going on at home, maybe they just got some bad news, maybe they lost a big deal. But if we just automatically go to giving someone the benefit of the doubt versus assuming the worst in someone, imagine the environment that you're creating in your office space, right? Because if we were working with someone, we would want someone to give us the benefit of the doubt, right? So finding the way to meet people where they are in order to give them the benefit of the doubt to create a safe space to work in. So I wanted to leave you with this final thought today, where I just mentioned meeting people where they are with grace, with understanding, with patience. You can create a wonderful workspace and environment just by being patient, by giving grace, by meeting people where they are. It creates for an environment to where you feel better, that you feel that it's an inclusive environment, that you belong there. And again, it goes back to the very first slide that I shared in terms of if you provide a space for people to feel supported, that you give them the resources to be successful, and you invest in your people, they are going to do so much more and go above and beyond for you. And so I'm so grateful to be able to share that final thought with you. I only had a few minutes today, so thank you for having me up on the stage. And before I leave, I feel like there might be one other thing that's going to come and share the stage with me. So I understand we have a special guest today, but we were just going to do a little giveaways, right? That's all we were going to do. I see that you're dressed up and everything. Oh, you're excited to be the keynote speaker. Oh, I'm so sorry. You guys have to stay even longer. We've got another speech ahead of us. I wonder, and I heard that you got a title promotion, Bear. CMO, Chief Mascot Officer. Is that right? Congratulations. Whoa. That's a lot. That's a lot. Get comfortable, people. I think that's it, Bear. We're so glad that you came out today to be, oh, wait, no. We're done. Everybody give Bear a round of applause. We're so glad that you came out today. All right, just some parting gifts for you guys. Thanks so much for being here. Make sure you stay for the reception and the networking afterwards. So thanks so much for being here.